we wanted to make sure that we had just the right person moderating this, because it's such a cool and interesting and growing field that really has a beautiful history now, and we wanted someone who was familiar with it and could ask the right questions, you know what I'm talking about. So our moderator tonight is, his name is Angel Mannion, and we like him for this for four really good reasons. Number one, he works for the San Diego Opera, our colleagues at San Diego Opera. In fact, he's the social media coordinator over there. Number two, we like him because he's a musician. He is a singer, a baritone, as a matter of fact. And number three, not just any baritone, but he's performed on some concerts that you may have seen in the last few years, such as Zelda Symphony of the Goddesses, maybe Final Fantasy Distant Worlds, Video Games Live, maybe. Was anyone in Star Trek Beyond last night? He was singing on that too. He's been all over.
Wow.
So that's great. But check this out.
I want to go there.
A couple years ago, he founded something called Folklore Guild, which is San Diego's first video game music ensemble dedicated to bridging the gap between video games and classical choral music. How about that? He's even going to release an album called Press Start later this year. And that's for cathedral organ and 30 professional voices featuring music from, get this, Kingdom Hearts, Super Mario 64, Everyone's Gone to the Rapture, The Witcher, Echo the Dolphin, Dragon Age Inquisition, Skyrim. Did we get the right guy for this or what? Ladies and gentlemen, give it a hand for Angel Mannion.
I am a video game scholar, or at least I consider myself to be, for video game music. So, yeah, it's just so cool to be here in front of you guys in San Diego. And without further ado, however, why don't we just bring on out Mr. Sakaguchi, and the translator tonight is Misako.
Hiromichi Tanaka, I don't know if you know.
Sega Genesis, how did Sega Genesis name in US?
Sega Genesis.
Yeah. No, 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 no,
no, no, no,
Secret of Mana.
Yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
So, they would be there.
So, the guy is Apple II. Apple II.
Oh, he taught him that, how to use the Apple II.
それでウィザードリーとかアルティマとかアルティマとかっていうゲームを遊んでハマっちゃってそのままゲームに。
So I got hooked on playing the game Ultima.
ウィザードリー。Of course, of course, I love. Do you know Zenith? Zenith is a 3D shooting game by Nancy Zibiri. Nancy Zibiri is main programmer of Final Fantasy.One, two, three.
Do you guys know that?
No. He's genius programmer on Apple II.
Yeah, so he's a genius.
So back to when you were in college, ultimately, Mr. Sakaguchi dropped out of university when he was studying electrical engineering, and.Jump to Square with Mr. Tanaka, who you just mentioned, and I want to know, like, what drove you to do such a thing, you know, to not only change a major or a career, but to jump ship on your education and just go straight on to a video game developing company that before it was really a huge moving thing.
大学をね、やめてからでも、やめてまででも、そっちの関係の電気エンジンのファイナルファンタジーのやる、うん、なんでそっちの方に行ったんですかって。
日本の大学って、国立と私立なんですか。
はい。In Japan, we have public college and private college.
国立がすごい授業量が少くて、今アメリカではその問題になってますけど。
はい。As we have a problem here that you know public college is very expensive.
Yeah, but in Japan, 当時は年間10万円だったんです。
10万円 Oh, it's really cheap in Japan back then. It's only
about
$1,000 a year.
その代わり8年間しかいられないんです。8年間で卒業できないと、なんとクビになっちゃうんです。中退になっちゃう、追い出されちゃう。
So, but you have to finish in 8 years, and if you can't finish in 8 years, you'll be dismissed. You're not going to get a degree.
だから僕は別に机にジャンプしたりとか。8年間ずっと在籍して、いつでも戻れるようにしといて、その間ずっと冒険してたというか、まあ、そしたらうまくいったんで、そのまま。
So I guess that 8 years, he didn't really need to graduate, but that during that 8 years, he kind of did, you know, these programs off and on, when, while he was going to college.
そう、だから多分ゲームでは、ゲームの当時はゲームを作るって職業もなかった、名前もなかったんです。ゲームデザイナーって言葉もなかったんで、そんなの職業になると思ってなかったから、まあ何年間か好きなゲームを作って、まあその8年のうち大学に戻って、やっぱりちゃんと社会に出なきゃっていうふうに思うんですよ。
So I guess that back then there's not even a word game programmer or there's no game that is made on the computer. So he did on his own to you know make sort of like hooked on to making the games.And that within a year, he was going back and forth to the college, and then when the time comes, he just goes and finishes the college.
Yeah, yeah.
What video games were you playing at this time?
So, what video games were you playing?
Oh, no, I was playing Wizardry, Shadow. Shadow Key? Heat?
Shadow Key?
Shadow Key? Like Wizardry game. Like game like Wizardry game. Shadow Keep.
Does anybody know that?
Was that Apple
II? Apple II.
Apple II.
You know, Coco? Coco.
Coco.
Yeah, Coco, yeah, I like. Penguin Software.
Penguin Software?
Transylvania.
Oh.
Adventure game? Yeah, yeah. Wizard and Princess?
Alright, so we can jump to when you were at Square. So at Square, what inspired you to create the world of Final Fantasy? Was it an idea that you had been thinking of in the back of your mind for a long time?
아, 한번 더 디스컬러 퀘스천. 아, 칼이 다 말랐어. 안젤을 봤지. 아주 디스컬러 스니 두 개. 인스파이어니까 먼저 PC에 어드벤처 게임 RPG 게임을 만들고
So I guess not necessarily inspiring, but on the PC he was making adventure
and RPG. RPG game.
RPG.
Yeah, on PC. Yeah,
PC.
で、ファミコンってわかりますか？ネスね。
ファミコンピュー
ター？
ネス。ネス、ファミコン
ピューター。では、当時は、当時は、そのカセットにセーブができなかったんです。セーブっていうのは、自分でプレイしてる途中の経過を記録することができな
かったんです。
当時そのカセットではない。
Yeah, back then was just a little teeny cassette, but you could really save.
Yeah, 通じてるか、大丈夫か。まあ、大丈夫。大丈夫、あやつ通じてる。通じてる。
Do you understand what I'm talking
about? Yeah, yeah, yeah. She's my daughter, and she's smiling now, so I check on her. で、それで、だから諦めてたんです、その、ファミリーコンピューターで。RPG ゲームを作るっていうこと。
So I kind of gave up making the games on the RPG software.
What? On NES.
On NES.
なので、でそこにドラゴンクエストっていうみんな知ってるのかな？ドラゴンウォーリアーとして、ドラゴンクエストってゲーム、ドラゴンウォーリア
ーですね。Do you know the
Dragon Warrior?
Yeah, Dragon Warrior.
それが出て、それの一作目が。やっぱり同じようにそのセーブできないんですけど、テキストで、テキストをこう32文字ぐらい、なんかデタラメなテキストをこう出てくるんですよ。で、それをメモして、次プレイするときにそのテキストを打ち込むと、なんていうか、それが暗号になって、そう、続けられるようにする。それがすごい画期的だと。
I guess that was, I guess when you play the game a certain period, there's a big text message.
About 32 characters.
Text. Yeah, code.
So he'll write it down, and then when he played next time, he had to punch it in. So he keep on playing.
That's like a save.
So you have that technique.
So then, when you go in this
game, there's no save before.
So that would be the first step that, oh, I could play RPG game just like this. And you know, reprinting it again. So that was the first idea that he got. That was the inspiration.
けど、それはほら、さっき言ったみたいに PC で、何作かそういうふうに RPG ゲームとかアドベンチャーゲームを作ってたので、僕としてはその PC ゲームのニュアンスで作りたいなと。ファミコンってちょっとこう、なんていうかな、ファミコンってこうマリオっていう感じなんですけど、なんかそれじゃなくて PC ゲームっぽい、なんか大人の街っていうか、なんかそういうのを作りたいと思ったのが、ファイナルファンタジー。
So I guess that I don't really want to say inspiring, but that will be the inspiration that, as on the RPG game, he wanted to make the game not like Mario's, like you know, on the Mario.
Yeah, I love Mario.
Make a game more like for grown-ups and the PC, you know, design.
In Final Fantasy, with the first game, the Nintendo Entertainment System had extremely limited resources compared to now in terms of hardware. Do you feel like the limitations in hardware and software actually play to your favor in only focusing on the story? Was it easier actually to make something so elaborate as Final Fantasy with just the limited resources that you had for that system?
その時はリミットがあるじゃないですか、作るのね、でそういう中で作っていくのに何かこう特別なものがあるんですか。
やっぱり一つグラフィックスをきれいにしたかったんで、訳せるかな。This is difficult to translate. いや、テクニカルしてます。
The beautiful graphics, that's
it. 当時はキャラクターがファミコンで256キャラクターなんで、でそれそのあのキャラクターを使って画面になってますか、こうタイルみたいにはみ込んでて絵を作るしかなかったんですよ。
Oh, so back then, there's like 256 characters. That only thing he could do was to put it in the.
Yeah, だから大抵はそのまあこっちだったらアルファベットの文字なんですけど、アルファベット256のうちいくつかをアルファベットの文字じゃないっけ。プラスがなんか例えば簡単。例えば30文字、日本語だと多いんですよね、51なんで、その50キャラクターぐらいをその文字に食われちゃうんですよ。文字も出さないといけない
から
、わかります、ね、絵には200、まあ、実際には200なくて、150ぐらいしかキャラクターが使えない。
So that I guess that there's 256 characters you wanted to, but like in alphabet, we have 26 alphabets, and Japanese alphabet is 51.、Mm.so he, when he was putting it as a character, that changed it into alphabets, the words. So he only had
150. 当時は、ブラウン管じゃないですか。
はい、
今の液晶と違って、もう操作線が走ってて、
And back then, the TV screen was a flat TV. It's not just like the flat TV nowadays, but it's a...
操作線ってなってるか。操作線ってわかんないか。いや、わかんない。わかんない。操作線。
操作線。And there's a, you know how when you film the TV, there's a line goes through
it? Yeah,
yeah, yeah. イタリア、yeah, yeah. なので、僕らは、ワンを見ればわかるんだけど、ワンのメッセージインプットって、下半分にベロンって出るじゃないですか。
As you know, the fantasy, Final Fantasy 1, if you know that...
だから操作線がここまで来た時に、このキャラクターのセットを無理やりプログラムで入れ替えてるんですよ。
So that line appeared, he put characters in it, he transferred the character into that line.
そう、そうすることによって、その見頃キャラクターを全部絵に使って、絵を描いてるんだけど、そうやって文字のキャラクターを出したいと。操作線が来たら、その見頃のを切り替えちゃうんで、強制的に文字の下に文字を出す。そうすると、いや、何が言いたいかというと、150キャラクターでしか絵が描けなかったのは、僕たちは見頃キャラクターを使えたので、FF1 はやっぱり他のゲームでちょっと絵が綺麗になったりする。難しい設定が。Sorry!
The line appeared, he was able to change into the character.And somehow,
I see he's talking about changing the character buffer during the retrace. Similar to like.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you. Here's a book called Racing to Being.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Be nice.
Scans out one line, and then while it's retracing, you quickly fill in the next buffer, and so you scan out the next line, it's a new set of graphics.
Yeah.
And that way you can get really a different line a different set of characters on each line of the screen display.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thanks. Thank you. Thanks.
Use your resources.
Yes.
Thank you. I'm going to jump forward a little bit. And can you describe your working relationship with Nobuo Uematsu-san during the early days of Square and when you met as their immediate connection?
最初からすごくいい関係ではあったんですけど、エピソードが1個あって、あ、まあ、there is an episode。あの、FF1、まあ、みんな知ってるんですけど、どっかで聞いてるかもしれない。FF1の曲を最初彼が10曲ぐらいかな、あの、まあ、当時のカセットテープ、CD ないから、入れてきて、それを聞いた時に、
So I guess back then we don't have a cassette tape, and he made about 10 songs for it. But you know, as you know, I put my all my emphasis and effort to make this Final Fantasy, so I rejected everything. So what he did was he changed the numbers of the music. It's the same music, but he changed the you know how it's set up.
Yeah. And it's wonderful. But
that's what he did. Like, so we talked about that when we had a drink with him and you know. So it's a very nice
relationship.
Yeah, it's a good relationship.
That's awesome. I want to hear the original Mario Bros. So, can you describe how the early brainstorming sessions went on between you and Uematsu-san for the iconic opening theme? But I think you just answered that. So. I'm going to move on. Final Fantasy is known for having amazing character development. Can you describe your creative process from start to finish in developing villains and heroes, and where do you draw your inspiration from in naming the characters?
Final Fantasy でね、まあアミューズのキャラクターがいっぱい出てくるんですけども、悪いヴィレンとかヒーローとかいらっしゃるんですが、その説明を
していただきたいと思います。名前ですか？名前のキャプテンの名前ということを教えていただきたい。はい。キャラクターはやっぱりすごく大事で、多分一番大事なものです、ストーリー。まあもちろん皆さん。
But as you know, the character is the main, you know, very important
part of the game.
So I guess that I wasn't really thinking about the characters then until end of the three. And I don't know if you guys know Mr. Torishima. He was the publisher of the magazine called Jump, the magazine, the Japanese comic magazine. For the first time, and he also there's Akira Toriyama, who's the creator of Jump. Yeah, he's you know the sensei, you know, right? So anyway, so after the Final Fantasy III, they had a meeting. And meeting him for the first time.
First time.
Yeah, meeting for the first time, he lectured him. Why is the Final Fantasy so bad?
そう、取島さんの言ってることはものすごく、まあその時も、あ、多分です。その後やっぱり正しいし、今の取島さんとは、食事をしたりして、僕にとっての師匠みたいな人なんですけど、彼からやっぱりキャラクターの大事さっていうのを知って、はい。Yeah,
so Mr. Torishima, you know, he realized that he's right, and you know, I still have a dinner with him, you know, now and then, and he's the one that taught me how the character is important.
まあだから4からの方が多分3までよりキャラクターが立ってるって言い方で分かりますね。キャラクターがもっと魅力的なんだと思うんですけど。Yeah,
so he feels that from the 4, you can see the difference in characters more but
そう、
the naming of the character, he just thinks about it spontaneously. There's no, you know, these meaning anything. So sometimes that amazes the staff. You know, it's a, I guess, it's a difficult names.
Okay, so it's important. We're talking about characters, and once you started putting more time and effort into developing them, which character at this point do you feel like you relate to the most?
Which color?
Pink?
How do you get a pink chocolate?
Pink
chocolate. There's a pie, right? I used to say that, but now I'm Deb chocolate. Deb
chocolate. I used to be skinny before. I guess
yeah.
Chubby now.
the white fat chocobo, yeah.
The fat one.
ones that are easier to translate. Were you surprised by the amount of success that Final Fantasy had in the United States, despite Final Fantasy 1 being released after Final Fantasy 3 had already been released in Japan? So were you surprised by the success that we had? My main question is, were you surprised that your Final Fantasy was so successful in the United States after its
debut? Oh, yeah, so no.
Very confident.
すごいアメリカで成功したくて、結構何度も足を運んで頑張ってたんですけど、なかなか難しくて。Yeah, I came here so many times to make it successful. で、セブンの時に、やっぱりCGになったことで、これはちょっと英語いけるんじゃないかっていう感じだったんです。すごく、その時は、それこそロサンゼルスかな? もうなんかダウンタウンディズニーの中のなんかどっかでミーティングした覚えあるんですけど、まあそこでもうセブンの時はとにかく、より頑張ってみたいと思って、セブンで初めて多分、彼らしたらメーター。
He believes that after seven, he made the sex scene that, you know, everybody thinks he did. I guess that they had a meeting in the downtown, you know, the Disney downtown, not the Disneyland, but yeah, he remembers that he had a meeting there to make him the seventh. And since the CG came out, it was a promotion meeting that they had in downtown.
で、それまではなんかやっぱりドット絵の、あの、三頭身とかありますよ。頭で勝ち、三頭、三頭身。はいはい。いろんな頭、三頭身、力が三頭身、座敷が三頭身。はいはい。そういうキャラクターはやっぱり、あの、アメリカではあんまり受けないんじゃないかとも言われたりして、その6までが受けなかった理由っていうのは。So
he believes that until the six wasn't that popular, was a main the character that he made. They call it the big head, small body.
Yeah.
そうそう、ドットエッジだよ。ドットエッジだからですよ。ドットで、ドットで作られた。ピクセル。ピクセル。ピクセル。ピクセル。それが最近のピクセルがいいとか言う人が多くなったんで。そう、ヒアリング。どういうことなんだ?What happens? Now that those characters are popular now, and what's happening?
Oh, yeah.
So yeah, there's a movie about the Pixel, yeah? Yeah. Yeah, he's in denial still.
forward to Final Fantasy VI. How many of you know Maria and Draco?
Oh, yeah.
I would like to know your inspiration behind creating this opera sequence.
I guess the changing of the instrument, that noiseless and I guess music.
Three. Three no grass noise. On this. The super ness is, I think, 16.
So I guess that since that all the technology is advanced, that he wanted to emphasize the music, more of a music with this opera.
While we're on that topic of having better capabilities of sound and emphasizing the music, I'm sure that PlayStation immediately opened up a whole new world for you. Can you talk about any struggles you faced into transitioning into 3D for Final Fantasy VII? Because I know that changed the game completely, so did you have any initial struggles with that?
いや、それはもちろん、コンピュータグラフィックスを入れなきゃいけなかったんで、 ですけど、1年間、7人ぐらいのチームだったかな、チーム組んで、シリコングラフィックスっていうコンピュータグラフィックス専用のマシンがあるんですよ。マシンっていうか、シリコングラフィックスっていう名前の、コンピュータグラフィックスを作るためのなんかコンピューターなんですけど、
それを作る、初めて、
ちょっとあやちょっと来て略したのでやってたのシーダボ
ックス。 CG, of course, the first time applying on seven, and then I guess the first group of seven of us and trying to do, there is a program called Silicon Graphic to use it to make the CG.
Yeah, expensive machine.
Yeah, very expensive machine.
Yeah, そこで1年間7人のチームを組んで、なんていうのかな、3D で描く RPG っていうのはどうあるべきかっていうのを結構研究したんですよ。そういうことをやったのが初めてで。
Yeah, it's been the first time, so about a year, the seven of us, they were trying to learn how to draw with the 3D.
そうですね、まあなんていうの、3D の RPG とは夏を言ってたんですね。まあそんなもの世の中になかったんですね、それまで。
Yeah, so back then, there's, you know, that's such a thing didn't exist, so they had to learn everything. Yeah, it was a difficult, very difficult time.
Okay, did your overall vision of the game always, since you had access to 3D modeling and the ability to shift camera angles, and then you added cutscenes in Final Fantasy VII for the first time, did you always have a cinematic experience that way in mind? I know that it was always very focused on the plot, but did you always have it, in your mind, was Final Fantasy always supposed to be like a movie experience?
I think you are Final fan of Final Fantasy VII, right? Okay. Hi.
Yeah, I believe so deeply that it's all about teamwork, and he met this one, he's still a best friend. He's the one that had the programmer for the CG. So yeah, they still keep in touch, and they're still friends with him. And I think it's all about teamwork.
当時はなんか、そのさっき言ったシリコングラフィックスっていうマシンに対抗して、シンボルクスっていうマシンがあったんですけど、これは AI のマシンで、AI のマシンなんです。なんか人工知能。で、なんか全然関係ないように思えるんですけど、当時はその人工知能用のマシンがすごく CG に似てて、そこの責任、なんと技術責任者だったのはそのさっき言ったプログラマーで最初に来てもらった、いまだに親友のやつっていう。
So I guess that that similar to go against the silicon graphic that they use for CG, that there's also a symbolic graphic. And it's very similar, this AT, AI machine is very similar, useful and similar for us to create the CG. And this guy, his name's Kazu, is the one that taught them how to use it, and we're still keep in touch with him. Yeah, because of him, that's where he is right now.
That's great. I guess in comparison, when you had first started the game, up until Final Fantasy VII, when you had the ability to make the game more like, much more like a movie, was that what you always had in mind?
そうですね、まあ、映画を作るっていうのは最初から考えてなかったんですけど、とにかくやっぱりハリウッドのやってみて思ったのはハリウッドの CG っていうのがすごいなっていうのがあって、ゆくゆくはやっぱりあの頃覚えてたのは例えばジュラシック・パークとか、ああいう映像世界でゲームをしたいって強く思ったので、やっぱりコンピュータグラフィックスのその強いチームを作りたかったっていうのが、はい、まあ、その後の映画作りとか、まあ、そのスクエアのビジュアル の方向性を決めた感じですね。はい、
So I guess that, you know, it's just that he was amazed with that, how, you know, the CG you can work, you know, you can work. So like by watching the Jurassic Park, how you can use the CG like alive, and we had a strong team with them, so.As a visual, always inspired by how CG can make it as a, the movie. He never really had the mind to make a movie. He didn't need to have it made out of a movie.
Great. I'm about to take audience questions, so I'm going to ask one more. Which theme for Final Fantasy do you feel are actually underappreciated? And conversely, are there any tracks that surprised you in how popular that they become?
Bad one. That's
it. Yeah, the one that.
Yeah, which one do you think is that, like, isn't as popular, but you like a lot, that should be more popular?
Well, I don't know. Me not know.
Nine. Nine.
I don't know.
anyone?
Oh, that's a Mystic Quest?
Yeah!
Oh, no.
Sorry, bad. Mystic Quest, I'm sorry.
Sorry. All right, at this point, I'm going to take questions from the audience. Oh, there's someone standing up back there. First one.
Sensei, I just want to say it's an honor to be in the same room as you. Thank you for everything you've contributed to humanity. where in Ueno is the office where you guys made Final Fantasy 1 back in 86 and 87? Because I've looked around many times and I just had trouble finding the location.
Tokyo. City name. I think Hiyoshi is near Yokohama. Then we moved to Ginza. Ginza. Yeah, Ginza's owner.銀座のなんかすごいビルに移っちゃって、で、お金がなくなって、その その後家賃が10分の1の引っ越しっていう、スクエアはそんなことばっかりやってた会社です。銀座はすごい高いじゃないですか。それはだから、ね、すっごいビルに入っちゃったんだけど、その頃、ビル1は出来上がったんだけど、売れたにもかかわらず家賃高すぎるんで、すごいボロボロと、その後する、そんなことばっかりやってたんですね。
I guess the first one he made in Hiyoshi City near...
No, near Yokohama.
Near Yokohama, I'm sorry. The Hiyoshi City near Yokohama. But his president bought moved the office to Ginza. And Ginza, as you know, it's a very expensive place. And, you know, he did conclude the Final Fantasy 1. So after he made it, they could only afford one-tenth of the rent there. So they had to move around and back and
forth. Yeah. Square was right, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Sir, yeah. Friend. Over here.
I just talked to you.
What led to picking Yoshitaka Amano as your concept artist back in the day? Great question.
Well, so I guess that he liked this one picture. He didn't know who did this picture. And this guy used to do a lot of novels, you know, little novel books. And then Mr. Koichi Ishii, who is a creator of a chocobo, said, well, what about this, you know, picture? What do you think? Oh, well, actually, before that, he said, well, there's a guy, you know, this Mr. Amano. Who the hell is he? I don't know him. No. Well, this is the picture that he drew. Would you like to take a look? Oh, this is the one. This is the one that I liked. So, I guess that's...
会いに行ったら、なんていうのかな、2つ返事で面白そうだからやろうって話になって、ただびっくりしちゃったのが、天野さんなりにそのファミコンのゲームを研究したらしくて、最初に上がってきたコンセプトアートがピクセルで、
うん、
ピクセルでワクワク描いてきた。僕にはちゃんとした絵を描いてほしかった。要は彼は研究して、ファミコンっていうのはそういうもんだって、うん、そんなお絵は僕らの仕組みに入ってそう、最初のピクショップをピクセル、うん、
So I guess that will have me, you know, meeting with Mr. Amano. And surprisingly, he was studying about the, you know, the picture too. And when he presented the picture, it was done by pixel style, which he didn't want the pixels, he wanted actually to draw a picture.
いや、まあ、もったいないです。今、多分その天野さんが描いたピクセルで撮っておいたら、多分すごい価値があった
と思う。
個人は多分そのままぐちゃぐちゃにな
ってるんですけど。
もったいない。
Regrets or maybe projects that you felt weren't as appreciated as you think they maybe should have been. I know you directed Final Fantasy, The Spirits Within.
Oh, and, who's seen that movie?
Oh, thank you. Thanks so much. Please buy DVD.
Were you surprised at all by the reaction when it came out in the U.S. market? And do you have any like mixed feelings about it now that it's been so long that it's out? Or do you feel that it just truly isn't as appreciated as you think it might need to be?
Oh, that would be Christmas there.
I am surprised.
I think, yeah, King's Grave, do you know King's Grave? Oh, yeah, King's Grave is good.
So after watching that, he was amazed with the picture, and that you know he really emphasized in 15 and all that rest of it.
Yeah, great movie. So do you know Terabato?
Yeah.
Terabato.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Please download.
How have you had to adapt to a changing audience and video game trends while still keeping the essential elements to the game? Can you repeat that question one more time? How have you had to adapt to the changing audience throughout the years and the changing video game trends while still keeping the essential elements to the game? How has he kept Final Fantasy fresh to new audiences?
I think the key to be successful with the Final Fantasy is that he always wanted to repeat, but when as an idea came up to my mind, we just put every emphasis to it. That usually you keep that little next episode to the next story, but they didn't want to do that. They just put whatever the idea that they had into this one production. So that next time when you start, you have a fresh start. You have nothing in your mind, in your head, so you were able to start fresh start.
That's fair.
Maybe.
There's another key to this.
Probably the first one, because we started with nothing. And we started with the zero. So that's the first one we did that. And also after the seven, because we did use that shiji.
But I'd like to interject a question. Of your non-Final Fantasy projects, which are you the most proud of? So the other side, the non-Final Fantasy.
I don't know. Ogamato.
Yeah!
What's your favorite? Outside of Final Fantasy.
As you contribute to the success of Final Fantasy VII throughout all these years, what made you decide to now release the remake? Mm-hmm. I know everyone knows Iconic Games, like Cloud Strife, the Block Party, and all that stuff, and it was such a high demand. What inspired you to now release the remake?
First of all, I want to say it's an honor to actually be able to ask you a question. I got two real quick questions. First of all, I'm holding my copy of my original copy of Final Fantasy here, Final Fantasy III, and this was a hand-me-down from an older family member of mine.
Is
the wrap still on this?
No, it's not like something. But my first question is, in this game, there happens to be one of my most favorite villains of all time, which is Kefka.
Yeah.
What inspired that villain?
Whoever he didn't like at the time.
You mean like a high school bully or something?
So I guess that's based on his mother.
Wow.
And Mike, just real quick, I mean I would be a fool not to take advantage of, but would you be able to sign my copy of Final Fantasy?
Sign his copy.
Sure.
That would be, I mean, right now.
Come on down.
What is the most that you like about the upcoming Final Fantasy?
What?
One more time.
What is the most that you like about the upcoming Final Fantasy?
What?
Upcoming 15.
Oh, 15 upcoming. Yeah. Talk about it. What do you like the most about it?
Demo版も、何ですか? Demo版も。 あれさ、車で旅なんかしないでさ、ラブーに連れてってもらえばいいのに困るんですか？
Did you think that, you know, instead of driving, did you think everybody wanted to go to Ramu?
They call Ramu and yeah, they can bring me easy.
Did you think about it?
まあでも、さっきも言ったけど、キングスグレーブっていう映画を見て、あの主人公がどうしてあそこに仲間といるのかっていうのとか、彼の気持ちとかっていうのをすごく考えさせる映画なんですよ。映画のそのゲームの中に、前説っていうか、前の話になってます。なんかゲームのストーリーの前の、その直前の話になってます。だから、キングスグレーブって映画が。だからそれを見ると、そのゲームのこの主人公のところの気持ちがよくわかるというか、か今ではもう僕もすごいプレイしてるとしょうがないし、まあ、ディレクターの田畑さんとはよく話をしてて、ちょっと見せてもらったりするんですよ。田畑ですよ、田畑。とても良さそうなんで、すごく、なんていうかな、まあ、ファイナルファンタジーがそうやって新しく、なんか15ですごくチャレンジしてるっていう感じを受けるんで、それすごく嬉しい。
Feelings of the what he's thinking about in that movie. I guess there's a little movie before the game he likes, and so he still talks about with Mr. Kabata that it's like on the 15th he's going to want to challenge Zenit.
I think 15th is good.
One more. Okay.
Last one, folks. Here you go.
Hi. Is there anybody that you have not worked with that you would like to work with in the industry, either video games or in Hollywood?
Who would you like to see him work with? Any suggestions from the floor?
Kojima.
Kojima-san, then? Oh, now he is Konami, so I can make with him.
Well, I believe we're all set. I would love to thank you.
So I